Hi, I'm Susan Rutledge, and in this video, I'll show you how to make the perfect bow in Adobe Illustrator. We'll be demonstrating a number of different techniques, so have a pencil and paper handy, and let's get started. I'll move to a document where I have the RGB numbers for the colors I'm going to be using. If you don't know how to use numbers to create colors, I'll leave a link to a tutorial that explains how to use the RGB and the CMYK color modes at the end of this video, and you'll want to check that out next. For this project, we'll start out with the ellipse tool, keyboard shortcut L. I'll click on the artboard to open the ellipse dialog box. I'm going to type in 5 inches for the width, tab down and type in 1 inch for the height and say OK. And then I'll get the anchor point tool. The keyboard shortcut is Shift C. Now it's actually located on the left toolbar and it would appear underneath the pen tool if it wasn't already selected. All you do is click on the pen tool to get that fly out menu. But I encourage you to memorize these keyboard shortcuts just to speed up your workflow. I'm going to click on the left anchor to add a point here. Then I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and I'm going to move this up where it's easier to see. And then I'll rotate the ellipse with the rotate tool, keyboard shortcut R. Illustrator places the rotate ball in the center of the ellipse, but I want to rotate on that pointed anchor. I'll hover over it and then press down the Option key and click down with my mouse to open the Rotate dialog box. I'll type in 35 degrees and say OK. Then I want to mirror or reflect this ellipse. So I'll get the Reflect tool, keyboard shortcut O, come over and hover over that anchor again. Press down the Option key and then click down with my mouse. I open up the Reflect dialog box and I want a horizontal reflection, so I'll click here and then press Copy. Now I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and let's move these down a ways. I want to make sure these points are perfectly lined up, so I'm going to select them, come over to the Properties panel, and click on Horizontal Align Left. Now I'll get the ellipse tool again, keyboard shortcut L. I'm going to start up in this area right here at the top of the loop. It doesn't matter at the moment because Illustrator is going to move that anchor as I drag. So what I'll do is with my mouse still down, I'm going to press down on the space bar on my keyboard and I can move the loop. I want to line up the top and the bottom. When I see that line along the bottom, that's Smart Guides showing me I'm right there lined up. I'll release my mouse. Now, if you don't see that line, go up to View and turn Smart Guides on here, or you can toggle it on and off with the keyboard shortcut Command U. Now I'll get the anchor point tool again, keyboard shortcut Shift C, and I'll add a point to this left anchor, and then get the direct selection tool, keyboard shortcut A, and make sure that this anchor is selected. Hold down the Shift key and drag to the left. Now holding the Shift key down constrains that movement to a horizontal move, and I'm going to come over until I intersect with those left anchors I already created, and then I'll release my mouse. And this gives us the rest of the right side of the bow. I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and I'll select all three of the pieces. I'm going to group them for now, keyboard shortcut Command G, and then we'll reflect this entire part of the bow using the reflect tool, keyboard shortcut O. I'll hover over the intersected anchors, press down the Option key, and click down with my mouse. With the reflect dialog box, I'm going to choose a vertical reflection and press copy and get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V. So now I have the upper part of the bow. I want to create the streamers and I want my streamers to be the width of the bow here. So I'll come over to the left toolbar, and behind the eyedropper tool, if I press down with my mouse, I have a flyout menu that gives me a measure tool. I'll select that, and I'm going to start at the top and just drag down to the bottom. And I see that the height is about 5.77 inches. So I'll release my mouse and close this out and get the rectangle tool, keyboard shortcut M, and click on the artboard to open the rectangle dialog box. And I'll type in 5.77 inches for the width, tab down and type in 7 inches for the height, and say OK. I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V. And let's move this up where we can see all of the rectangle. I'm going to add an anchor to the center bottom. So I'll press down on the plus key on my keyboard. And I'm going to line up my cursor with the center bottom of the rectangle. Smart Guides is showing me when I'm lined up, and I'll press down to add an anchor. Now the anchor is added and selected, and I can tell that because it's filled in while the other anchors are hollow. So let's come up now to Object, Transform, Over, and down to Move. And I don't want a horizontal move, so I'll type in 0 here. But I'm going to type in -2 for the vertical move and say OK. And Illustrator moves the anchor 2 inches up. Now I'll get the direct selection tool, keyboard shortcut A, and I'll lasso over the top left and right anchors, and then get the scale tool, keyboard shortcut S. Now, with the scale tool selected, I'm going to start with one of these anchors, hold the shift key down so that when I drag to the center, both the left and the right anchors move at the same time. Now, when I have about 3/4 inch at the top, I'm going to release my mouse and get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V. Now, to create an angle for my ribbon, I'll get the rotate tool, keyboard shortcut R. I'll move my cursor to the left top anchor, hold down the option key, and then click. That opens the rotate dialog box, where I'll type in 25 degrees and say OK. Then I want to create a reflection of this ribbon, so I'll get the reflect tool, keyboard shortcut O. Hover over this left anchor, hold down the option key, and click down with my mouse. That opens the reflect dialog box. We do want the vertical reflection. This time we'll say copy, and that creates our two ribbons here. I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and for now we'll group them, keyboard shortcut Command G, and move them over, and let's center them on the bow, and I'll move them to the back. I can either come up to Object, Arrange, and Send to Back, or I can use the keyboard shortcut Shift Command Left Bracket. Now to create the knot, I'll get the rectangle tool, keyboard shortcut M, click on the artboard to open the rectangle dialog box and type in 0.8 for the width, tab down and type in 1.4 for the height and say OK. Then I'll get the direct selection tool, keyboard shortcut A, and I'm going to drag on one of these handles as far as I can to the center until I see the red lines at the top and the bottom. That's as far as I can go, and I'll release my mouse and get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and drag this over to the center of the bow. Now let's select everything and move it down in the center. I'll get the eyedropper tool, keyboard shortcut I, and click on the medium red color to apply that to everything. And then, just so you can see the various pieces, I'm going to go ahead and add a 1-point black stroke. We'll remove that in a little bit. Next, I'm going to have to do some ungrouping. So I'll select the right side of the bow, keyboard shortcut Shift Command G, and select the left part of the bow, Shift Command G, and then select the ribbons, Shift Command G, and all the pieces of the bow are ungrouped. Now I can select the big part of the right side of the bow, and I'm gonna get the mesh tool. It's on the left toolbar. Here's what it looks like. I'll click here. The keyboard shortcut is U. I'll come over to the bow, and I'm gonna line the mesh tool up with the center of the bow, and then just a little bit to the left of these anchors here. So I'll click here, and this anchor right here in the center is selected. I'll get the eyedropper tool, keyboard shortcut I, and I'm gonna click to apply this lighter red, and Illustrator adds a beautiful highlight to that side of the bow. I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and click on the left part of the bow. Get the mesh tool again, keyboard shortcut U, lining up the center and just a little bit to the right of these anchors. I'll click again, get the eyedropper tool, keyboard shortcut I, and apply the light red. I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V. I want to add a highlight to the ribbon. I'll select the right side, get the mesh tool, keyboard shortcut U, and I'm going to click pretty much in the center here. Get the eyedropper tool, keyboard shortcut I, apply the lighter red, get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, select the left ribbon, get the mesh tool, keyboard shortcut U, click in the center, get the eyedropper tool, keyboard shortcut I, apply the light red again, and get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V. Now I want to select my loops, so I'm going to select the top right, hold down the shift key, select the top left, come down still holding the shift key down, selecting the left side, and selecting the right side, and we're going to bring those to the front. Keyboard shortcut shift command right bracket. And we see quite a change here, but I want to add even more depth. So with those loops selected, I'll come up to Effect, Stylize, Inner Glow. I'm using a normal mode. I'm going to click on the color fill icon to show you how to choose the color. Now I'm going to use this darker color. I've already got it applied, but what you'll need to do is come in under RGB and type the RGB numbers here, 119, 18, and 24, and say OK. I'm going to leave the opacity at 60% and the blur at 0.125 inches, and I'm applying the inner glow to the outer edge, and I'll say OK. That's looking pretty good. I see I still have some black stroke here, so I'll select the bow, come over and click on the stroke icon and remove the stroke, and click on the artboard. I'm going to select the large left piece, hold down the shift key, and select the large right piece. Come back up to Effect, and because I'm going to use the same values that I used for the loops, all I have to do is click on Apply Inner Glow, and they're added in. Now let's do the same thing with the ribbons. I'll select the left side, hold down the shift key, and select the right side, and come back up to Effect. Click on Apply Inner Glow, click on the artboard to deselect those, then I'll select my knot, move it to the front, keyboard shortcut shift command right bracket, I'll get the mesh tool, keyboard shortcut U, and click about a fourth of the way down in the center, and then get the eyedropper tool, keyboard shortcut I, and apply this lighter red to the bow, then get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, click on the artboard then to deselect the knot, and then select it again, and go back up to Effect and apply the inner glow there. And here is our perfect bow. Now you can resize this bow to any size you want. I'm going to select all of the pieces and group them, keyboard shortcut Command G. Then I'll go up to View, down to Show Bounding Box. The keyboard shortcut is Shift Command B. And using the bounding box, I can hold down the Shift key, drag from any corner, and resize the bow to whatever size I want. I'm going to undo the move though because I want to leave it big, so I'll use the keyboard shortcut Command Z. And once again, here's our finished project. And you can use whatever colors you want. I wanted a light red for highlights, I wanted a medium red for the base color of the bow, and I wanted a dark, deep red for those shadows. And if you want to use some colors that you don't have in your swatches panel, I'm going to leave a link to my color series to show you some different ways you can easily do that as well. Well, I do hope you've enjoyed this video and learned a few techniques along the way. I want to invite you to subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell so you don't miss any of my future tutorials, and I'll look forward to seeing you again next time. Thank you so much for watching. Bye now.